Hello and welcome to the video tutorial for MTI Commerce's Simple Inventory for eBay. To begin with, you need to log into your eBay account and then click on the My eBay button here at the top of the page. And once you've done that, it'll take you to the screen you currently see. If you go ahead and click on the Applications tab, it will take you to your Applications page. And now if we scroll down, you'll see the MTI Commerce logo and it says Simple Inventory for eBay. Just go ahead and click on the blue start button to launch the application. Now, once it's launched, the main screen you see is called your business picture. And from here, you're able to immediately see information regarding your inventory. So you're able to see the total number of units you have on hand, the total value of your inventory, and the total selling price of your inventory. And this would be if you were to sell all of your items today, this is exactly how much you would get. On the left is the menu, which you can use to navigate the application, or you can use any of the quick links in the reporting box to go immediately to that area. Now, over here under the inventory heading, if we go ahead and click on items, this will take you to a page where you can view all of your listings. Now, to quickly navigate to a specific listing, you are able to search by keyword. And this is available at the top of the app. Now on the screen, you are able to quickly see necessary information for your listings, such as the description, the department, the cost on your end, and the starting price of the auction, or if it's a buy it now, you can see the fixed price. You can also see the supplier, and most importantly, the total number of units you have on hand. Now, if you ever need to add an item to your inventory that you are not selling on eBay just for inventory purposes, you can click the Add New Item link at the bottom of the page here. And this will allow you to create a new item. So you can enter an item ID, the title, or what you want the item to be called. You can put it into one of your departments and a supplier. You can enter your cost and then put the number of items, the number of units that you have on hand, and then just click the blue submit button, and this will create that item. Now, this will not post the item as a new listing on eBay, but it will allow you to include it in your current inventory in the application. Now, back on the items page, for any listing, you are able to remove it from the system. For example, if you have sold out of it and you no longer plan on selling it and you don't want it to show up in your reports, you simply need to click the red X next to the listing or the item name and then just click the yes button and it will be removed. To edit an item's information, you just need to click the magnifying glass next to an item and this will bring you to a more detailed view of that listing. From here, you're able to assign the item to a department, a supplier, you can add an SKU, manufacturer number, or location, and you're also able to edit the cost. Towards the bottom of the screen, you are also able to edit the number of units you have on hand, the maximum on hand that you would like to ever have, and you can set a threshold for what determines if that item is a hot or slow selling item. And those are numbers that you determine on your own, but by setting those up, you will be able to run hot item or slow item reports in the application. Now, if we go ahead and click on departments in the application, you are able to see any departments you have created. Now, when you initially sign up for the application, it does create two departments. That would be Arts and Crafts and Miscellaneous Department. To set up a new department, you can start by clicking the Add New Department link on the bottom of the app, and then fill out the appropriate information, so just the department name. You are able to specify parent-child departments or sub-departments, like so. And you can enter any comments or any additional information you'd like, and you just click the blue submit button, and it creates your department for you. Now, back on the department screen, it works just the same as the item screen you saw previously. If you'd like to delete a department, you just click the red X next to it, and then just click yes. Now, if you do get a message that tells you that you have inventory in that department, you just need to remove the inventory from that department, and then you are able to delete it. And just like the items page, if you click the magnifying glass next to a department, it will allow you to see a more detailed view for that department as well as edit information if you would like to. Now, the next screen under inventory is the supplier link. So if we go ahead and click on that, that takes us to our suppliers. And at first, one example is set up for you, just showing the reserve for MTI and some generic business information. To add your own suppliers, you would just click Add New Supplier at the bottom of the app, and then fill out any information that you have. And once you've done all of this, you just go ahead and click Submit, and that will save the supplier into the application. Now, it's not necessary for every seller to set up supplier information. Maybe you purchase items from yard sales or estate sales, so you only buy from a certain person once. Now, we've just added the feature, so if you need it, you do have it. If we go back to the suppliers page, it works just like the items page and departments page you've seen previously. If you'd like to delete a supplier, you just click the red X next to the supplier's name, and then you just click yes. And if you'd like to see more detailed information or edit information on a supplier, you just click the magnifying glass icon, and then click the blue edit button, and then edit whatever you'd like. And just go ahead and click Submit. The last and likely the most useful feature for any eBay seller is the inventory reporting. If we go ahead and click on that link in the menu, this will take you to the report screen. And here you're able to run three basic types of inventory reports, selectable from this dropdown. So there's general inventory, hot selling, and slow moving. For the hot selling and slow moving reports, those are determined by thresholds that you set in the items part of the application, so likely at this point you can't run them. For the purposes of the demonstration, we will just deal strictly with the general inventory report. You are able to filter the report using any of these variables that you see, and there are specific options you can choose to sort the results down here at the bottom. But for our purposes, we will leave everything blank and just go ahead and click the blue submit button. And now your browser will ask you if you want to open or save this file. It is a PDF file, so we'll just go ahead and open it. And then let's go ahead and maximize. Now, here you have a convenient and easy to read report showing all the necessary information regarding your current inventory status. So you've got the eBay ID number, the description or title of that listing, the department you have it in, the total number of units on hand, your replacement cost, the starting price of the item, and also if you've set up your suppliers, it'll show you the suppliers as well. And with this report, it is a PDF file, so you are able to print it out or save it to your computer, whatever you'd like to do, it is yours to keep. Now, if we close this report and go back to the application, the last three parts are actually really simple to go through. If we go ahead and go into eBay Sync, from here you can reference the last time an end of day was run, or the last time a listing sync was run. And you can see you've got these three blue buttons. The sync inventory button will be grayed out and you won't be able to click it. It runs the first time that you sign up if you are a Selling Manager Pro subscriber, and it doesn't need to run after that. For the sync end of day and sync listing buttons, clicking them schedules that process to run, but it does not run instantly. Depending on the number of listings that you have and the amount of traffic on eBay's servers and on our servers, that process can take anywhere from 15 minutes to a few hours to actually complete. Now, the sync end of day process searches the eBay servers for any new sales that you have made and adjusts your inventory in the application accordingly. The sync listings option searches eBay for any new listings that you have posted and then pulls their information into the application. Now, you can run these processes as frequently as every 3 hours if you would like, but we would recommend you run it at least once a day to keep your information up to date. The My Account link just shows you what contact information MTI Commerce has for you in the event that you submit a question or we do need to get a hold of you. For security reasons, I'm actually going to blank out the screen so you can't see my contact information. But this information is pulled directly from eBay, so if you do need to edit it, you need to do so on eBay. Now, the last feature to cover is the Ask MTI Questions link. So if you have a problem, a suggestion, or a question, and you want to get in touch with us, you just go ahead and click the Add New Question link, and then go ahead and enter a subject. And actually, this actually works exactly like a word processor. So down here, you can actually enter your question. Now, depending on your question, we will either contact you by email or by telephone. And that is listed up here at the top of the screen. If you would prefer to be contacted a specific way or you have a different contact method that you'd like us to use to reach you, please include that in the text area before you click the blue submit button. Now that concludes our video tutorial for Simple Inventory for eBay. If you liked the application or found this video helpful, please feel free to leave us feedback on eBay. Remember that eBay counts anything less than 5 stars as a negative feedback. If you don't know how to leave feedback for an application, we do have a short video, so please watch it. Thank you and have a great day.